Probably hard to see, but went outside and got a rock and broke it. I don't know if this will make any kind of texture, but I did this years ago and just used the jagged edge to make a kind of a texture in my clay for fur. A friend of mine she helped me with sculpting back years ago when she lived here. She lives now in Arizona. And she was telling me, well, I remember when you went outside and got a rock. And you know, had the broken edge on it, and you used that as kind of like a texturing tool. I'll try this one. It's got some weight to it, so it pounds into the clay really nicely. But the thing is, I don't want it to give a particular pattern. I want it to be fluid, just like fur. Yeah, I might have to go out and look for more broken rocks, or break some more rocks. It's kind of fun. Anything can be used as a tool. Just gotta have the right. It gives a kind of a mottled fur texture, doesn't it? Well, I don't know if you can see it or not, but I can. Yeah, that's not too bad, actually. What I do is I change from this end to that end and see what we get. Dang! Hard to hold on to a small round stone. That's my excuse and I'm sticking with it. Anyway, that's not bad, actually. It gives one of those textures that people will say, how do they do that? Well, now you know. Well, I'm going to continue doing this, I think, tomorrow. Today I was cutting lawn, and didn't have much time to sculpt. And I ended up clipping off one of these sprinkler heads. I think my landlord's out there working on it, so I need to go out and take a look. All right. Good night, everybody. Rocks as a tool. Back to the Stone Age.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.